Good morning, everyone. A very good morning. Shall we begin the session? Today's topic is the functions, and in the last class we have finished with the Boolean expression, Boolean operator, that is used with the logical operations also, that is used with the string operations. So whatsoever the data we are using up, that is used with the that we have discussed in the last class, yesterday's class. Next part is the functions. So let's move to the function, that are the advanced parts. Operator that will be used with the predefined actions on the data types. Let's begin with the session again. So when we called about the functions that are the advanced operator with the predefined actions on the database, and there are a number of functions that is built into the code fusion that is used with the CSMX, that is code fusion languages. We can say that functions are maybe array function, that may be a date time function, that may be a decision evaluation function, and coding encryption function, file directory function, formatting function, international function, list function, mathematical function, miscellaneous functions, query function, security function, swing function, structure function, and undocumented function. These are the list of the functions that is available with the Core Fusion markup language, that is CFMX. And these are one of the wonderful examples, wonderful functions that is given, but they played a lot in these category, they played a role in the Core Fusion markup language, and this is another we can security initials also that provides the markup language that uses with the markup language that is available for this markup data. These functions are available with the data, these functions are available with the scenarios, how they are used, why they are used, what is the main advantage of using that. Okay. So let's look up what are the various functions that will be available over here, what are the various data that will be used, that will be carried out with the homogeneous, heterogeneous data that will be used over here. So these are the functions that will be used, that will be carried out with the record. Whatsoever the record, whatsoever the data we are carrying out, that will be given the record, that will be given with the data that we can initialize, that we can use, that we can judge how we can maintain the data, how we can routine the data, how we can make the data successful. That is, for example, when you say about the array function, so this is how the array will be used and how that function will be generated out for making the array functions. Next is the date time function. Next is the decision evaluation functions. So this, that is a Boolean expression that will be used. So how we are using up, how we are taking up the Boolean expression that will be used for the encryption, decryption, and coding. Then next is the file or the directory function. There are two types, one is a file, one is a directory. Combination of the files is known as a directory also. Then formatting functions, international functions, list functions, mathematical functions, miscellaneous functions, query functions, security functions. So whatsoever the function we are using up, whatsoever the data we are using up, that is used to make the data, that is used to make the accessible data, security functions, sync functions, structure functions, that will be used, we can say, after fetching the result, to get the result. That will be available in the Core Fusion markup language. There are the functions. And you are also referred to RBB, the literature for detail about the individual functions available in CFMX. Now next is the flow control statement. So flow control and decision making also requires a control statement. And CFMX provided, or CFMX provided, there are three different types of conditional control statement. One is if-else statement, switch statement, loop statement. So there are three parts, switch, if-else, and the loop. And these three will be used for the decision making for the flow of control that has provided with the conditional operations. And the syntax for given that is used for the two-way branching, that is used with the if-else statement, is CFIF, logical expression EQ2, execute block 1, execute block 2, then CFIF is also closed. So this is CFIF, logical expression EQ2, EQ1, then there's a logical expression that is also given with the Y, G, D, X, and the multiple branching switch statement complex has the following functions, has the following syntax. So this is the syntax of the one way or the multi-way branching statement. So this is the CF switch expression, then CF case value 1, execute block 1, CF case value 2, block 2, value 3, block 3, and then CF case will be closed and the CF switch will be closed. So this automatically makes, or this automatically makes the switch statement that is complex at the following syntax, that is the multi-way branch. Now these statements will be available with the value 1, value 2 and the value 3 that is given over here. And this expression is also assumed to be valid, possible to evaluate and also producing a value compatible with the values in the CF case tags. And there are several types of the loop, and we illustrate the loop statement with the simplest, often referred as a for loop. So this also referred as a for loop that is given with the index loop count from start number to end number. So this index will be the loop count, but so about the loop count that is used. Then execute loop, then CF loop will be closed. So when a CF loop will be open, then CF loop will be. Then there is a loop count that will be incremented by the 1 for the loop started out that starts with the value assigned to start number and ends with the value specified for the end number. So it starts with the start number and ends with the end number. And other components are also included with the loop count with the start number and the end number. And there are other languages also that are used with the CFML. And most of which are the output, include and comment. These are the three types of the common output or files that are the languages. Output tag permit displaying the result from CFMX operations. For example, the result from a database query, CF output query, query name, maximum rows, max rows, max group, start rows, then text, and CF output will be closed. So one CF output will be used for the opening of the tag, how many rows are available, what is the group that is used, and then there is a text. Then there's the CF output that will be closed, where the query name is a name given in a previous query tag and max is the maximum number of the rows wanted, and the row specifies the rows from which to start output, from which to follow. And this tag also generates a display of the content of a collected query result. So whatsoever the data will be collected out, that will be taken out with the query result with the query object. And the CF include tag permits references to other CF templates also. The CF template will be used with a syntax that is very much simple. CF include template name, where template name is the absolute URL on the or the relative address of that to the template, and this tag functions similar to the call to a routine. So there will be a call routine, there will be a UR routine, there will be a relative address routine that will be given as a template. This is very much similar to the call to a subroutine. And CFML also includes a tag for non-executable remark that is very much simpler but not identical to the HTML remark tag. So one is a tag, one is a text, then the three dashes and a blank before and a blank, three dashes following the text are also required in contrast to the HTML remarks. The two dashes before and after the text. So there are two dash, there are two remark that will be used, that will be carried out with the data, that will be carried out by following the text, by following the HTML requirements. Remarks with the required data. And three dashes are also used, that is the following require the data. And and these will be included in contrast to the HTML remarks with the two dashes before and after the text. Then this is the next example that you have to read and tell me the solution of this. First of all, let I have it tell you. No, don't worry. This is a guessing game example. Just read out. If there's any doubts, any clarification, then please clarify. Just read out. This one guessing game example.
Yeah.
Have you studied about that guessing game example? So what do you observe about this? Yeah, that is implemented with the CFM access that I agree. But there are two parts in this. When you submit an answer, you will get either feedback or you will try to implement it. This example, as we know, in this course is implemented for you to try out. And for running that example, a link is provided at the end of the session. And this example is a simple guessing game. You will be asked to guess the sum of all the integers from 1 up to the number that is generated randomly. For example, if I give the number as a 7, so this will go from the 1 to the 7. And when you submit your answer, you will either get a feedback confirming the correct guess or message that your guess was formed together with the correct terms. So, now, I recommend that you start by running your complete or example by a couple of the time, that is, use the back button to return to the start and refresh the display. And when you feel acquired or when you feel acquainted with the game, then proceed to the study of the templates. Now, each and every application must have a extension that is known as the application.cfm template. And the purpose is to specify the properties which are valid for all other templates also. And this is a typical example that is given that must include this template must include the CF application tag, but then also include other tags also. And this is used for guessing example that is very simple. The application.cfm, CF application name equals to guess, session management equals to yes, session timeout equals to create timestamp 0030. This will be given as a hash, and the first statement is giving the template name within a comment tag. And this template or this comment is also different from the comment that you may know from the HTML, because HTML have a different comment and this have a different comments. Now the second statement that is given, this is a comment that is in a different format, and the second statement is a CF application that is a name equals to guess, as we know. And this has a three attributes. One is a name that specifies the name of the application, whatever name we are given. It's not mandatory that we give the exact name or anything. So we give any n number of the name. Then next is the session management that says about the application must remember, or application must remember the session variables, because the session management is either true or the false or yes or the no. If it is true, then it will validate the session, otherwise it is no. The application must remember the session variables, and finally the session timeout that specifies the length of time in days. What is the duration of the length? That is the length of the time in days, hours, minutes, seconds. Now system also must remember these variables if the user is inactive or active. And this template can also include other tags as well that will be seen, that will be included in the session, that will be included in the other variables also. And the game problem itself is a very simple dynamic application containing only two display templates, or the second depends on the information. What information? That information that is submitted from the first and makes the application dynamic. The first template is a name index for CFM that eliminates the possibility that the uninvited visitors are also browsing the content of our folder. and the task to be solved by this template is to present the game for the user and collect his or her game and guess by means of a form. And next parameter, that is an important parameter, that is given with the game is a random upper limit for the integer to be summed up. The task for the second template that is also given with the response for CFM that is used to calculate the correct answer to the problem, decide whether the guess submitted is correct or not, and present the conclusion for the user. But the main conclusion, how it is carried out and how to put the conclusion, how to put the guesses that is correct or not. This template index.cfm looks like the number that is a pn on a part of the script, but that are placed here to make it easier to the different parts of the template. So this index or CFM, then CF set, tab equals to randomize, second now, and CF set, session to target, range, that is the range is from 50 to the 100, then H2, that is for the heading 2, then font color red, case font, H2 will be closed. Form action equals to response for CFM. Now the action will be given as a response for CFM, and that is also the critical form. That category will be given as a form, that will be given as an index, that will be carried out, that will be used up for the session. That is action equals to response or CF, then CF output. When I say about the P, then my name is that we have to create a text box. So my name is input type text name P. And I guess the sum of the all the integers from P to V, session target, P, input type, case, this is the example, that will be given for the P tag. The CF output will be closed. Then P input type equals to submit. Now we are taking out the submit button, then the form will be closed. Now this figure shows the invitation to submit a guess for the evaluation. This is a guess. Then my name is Vin. I guess the sum of the all the integers from 1 to 52 is 2500. Then submit, and this also illustrates the CF site and the first line that we command that is given over here is a tab, and that gives a value computed by the CF function, that is the randomize function. This function will be given, and the purpose is to take a random seed for the next line, and that is obtained by using the second at the moment of execution as an argument. And if you look carefully at the expression, you will see that there are in fact three nested functions that will be given. So now there is a time, year, date, hour, minute, second. And the intermediate second that given or that extract the second from the time object. And while the outer function uses the second to generate a random state. So there are three parts, two parts, now and the second. That will be given as